Well, hello, a very warm welcome to the Sound of Silence with myself, DrumPIPO. And you know how we do it every single week. This time around, I'm hanging out with one of my brothers, Africa's finest drummers that you can ever think about. Look, this guy has worked with the likes of AKA, he has worked with Slilo Solota, he's worked with Lira, and so many, many great South African artists. He's also toured with Israel Hilton and so many, many great guys. It's gonna be beautiful right here on the Sound of Silence. You don't want to miss a thing. This show is made possible by Turnkey Music, a music shop based in Malibongwe Drive in Randburg. If you need musical equipment, if you need to service your equipment, you can come in store or check them out on their website, and I'm sure they'll be able to help you and assist you get the right equipment that you have been looking for so long. One more time, a very warm welcome to the Sound of Silence with myself, DrumPIPO. Stay tuned.
The Sound of Silence with DrumPIPO.
All right, welcome back to the Sound of Silence with myself, DrumPIPO. And like I told you guys today, I'm chilling with an amazing brother. He is a drummer. Look, he does so many, many things. My brother, Leagan StarChild.
What's up, brother?
Welcome to the Sound of Silence, man.
Thank you so much for having me, brother.
Excellent.
Thank you.
Tell me, where from the name StarChild?
Yo. To put it simple, I guess it really came from me not feeling like I'm from this earth, if anything, you know?
Mm.
And feeling like I was born of the stars. So that's how I came about calling myself Star Child.
Wow.
Because it's a child born of the stars.
Mm. Yeah. And you have been a drummer for so many years, right?
Yeah.
Tell me a little background about your craft.
Wow. I started playing drums from like the age of 2.
Mm.
Played in church and did the whole
thing.
Were you
in nappies?
You know?
Like,
bro, I was in nappies playing, man. I was in nappies, man. You know, running around and then jamming some drums, you know?
Yeah.
So that was literally the vibe, man. Both my parents are musical. My dad's a bass player.
Okay.
My mom sings.
Mm.
So I grew up in church.
Yeah.
Just being on the side, you know,
mm.
doing the things and learning and growing through church. And
Yeah,
man.
Yeah, but look, it's not easy being a drummer, and having an album.
Yes,
you know,
or
being a solo musician as a drummer. You know, at which point did you realize that look, it's about time I start putting out my work out there?
I mean, it was all birthed about 6 years ago.
Okay.
Where I decided, you know what? Let me. Just kind of take a look into creating my own music, you know, and find out what exactly the sound is that I like. Because I've played so many genres of music that I never ever like looked at myself and like what I enjoy, you know, what I want to play. And as time went, I guess it was more of a collective thing. Like I wanted to start a band, if anything, you know. So Ikioto was really a band concept.
Oh, okay.
And as time went on, it started developing a little differently because I was writing majority of the music. And when I eventually got signed, it was they wanted to sign me as an individual instead of signing a band. So that's kind of how it all came about in that sense. But I think the biggest thing with this record was the fact that a lot of drummers are not seeing themselves as artists.
Yeah. Why do you think that's the case, though?
Most of the time, we are seen as background, you know, because we are foundation of the music.
Mm.
But many artists have shown us that it doesn't matter what exactly you play, what instrument you play.
Yeah.
I mean, for instance, a perfect example is like a flautist.
Yeah.
A flautist can't really be seen on its own in music, you know?
Yeah.
But collectively makes sense. That's why it makes sense for a flautist to write music with musicians or to create around music or something, something other than their sound. Yeah. So my sound as a drummer on its own, it's more percussive. It's not melodic.
Yeah.
So that's where the trick comes in, you know. And because of the fact that I had both in me, I had melodies and harmony inside of me, as well as the percussive side of things. Yeah. And I just couldn't let it go, you know.
That's right.
It was one of those things, like, whether or not I'm writing for myself, which I didn't know at the time, or whether I'm writing for a band, which I thought I was doing, irrespective of it came to a point where it made sense.
That's
you
it.
Know, it made That's sense it. Through the process of writing. It made sense to be able to be in the background, but to still be able to shine as an artist.
Yeah.
And so that's why I forced to pursue the career, you know? Especially because there's not a lot of us out there, honestly.
Not at all. I mean, a lot of drummers rather want to be backing artists than be the forefront.
Yes, it's very true, yeah.
But what are some of the challenges that you've had trying to be at the forefront?
I guess a lot that comes with being an industry drummer. You are always booked either for sessions where it's like you coming into studio and it's just you playing over other music. So just as a drummer, and then you are booked into a band.
Yeah.
So most people see themselves as that because that's how they're getting booked.
That's right.
You see. So you get stuck in that thought pattern because society's kind of forced you to think that way because they like, when we need someone to back us, we'll call you sort of thing, you know? That's one of the challenges that we face as percussive
players.
Yeah.
Do you musicians. Think you'll get to a point where you will stop playing for artists and just play your music?
In all honesty, I would love to be able to produce and work with artists.
Yeah.
More than play for them.
That's right.
Mainly because not only have I done this for many years, but I feel like as musicians in bands, until respect changes,
that's right,
where you're not seeing me as the drummer in your band, but you're seeing me as an asset.
Yeah.
Once that changes, I have no problem playing for artists.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
You know what? Hold it right there. You know, we I'm not gonna take much of your time.
Oh,
we're just gonna do your first song, and we're gonna have some more talk.
Awesome.
I love this.
Beautiful. Thanks
take
so
it
much,
over, man.
Perfect.
Loving me easy at all. Even when the going gets tough, I choose to stay. I choose to stay. Soon I will rise again. With my heart in my hand, no matter what comes my way, I'll live on day by day. Live my life like a fiend, slowly tearing at the seams here. But I've gotta find my way out of here. Live my life like a fiend, I'm slowly tearing at the
All right, welcome back one more time to the Sound of Silence with myself, DrumPIPO, and you heard that amazing music. Hey, look, I don't know what to do to myself. My brother, that was good music, man.
Thank you so much.
I felt like, you know, like three or four drummers were playing all together.
Yeah, I hear that a lot, funny enough.
Yeah.
Awesome, man.
Tell me, so what inspired your new album?
What inspired this album was really a lot of lessons learned through a lot of life challenges, really, you know.
Yeah.
And when the record really started, it was myself and a good friend of mine, Francis.
Yeah.
He recorded everything and tracked everything.
Oh, okay.
He was behind a lot of things people will never know, but you know, I mean, the guy's everywhere and anywhere, you know.
Yeah.
My another close friend of mine, Tando, Tando Magic Keys.
Okay.
And Earl Breezy.
Yeah.
And Jaden Barron.
Okay.
So we were in a room together, and we sat and brainstormed because we were tired of of putting in hard work into another artist's dream, and and them not being able to actually sit back and see
even appreciate
the vision,
just
understand the vision, and then guide us.
Yeah,
you know, because we're seeing this for you in that sense, you know.
Yeah.
From that, once we started writing, it was birthed of a place where we just wanted something for ourselves.
Yeah.
You know? And as we went along, man, I was going through a lot of things in my life, you know, a lot of challenges and finding myself in very tricky situations where I understand the problem, but I can't get myself out.
Mm.
You know, and that's how Fiend actually came about. I wrote Fiend based off me being depressed and not understanding why, because I know depression and I know what it takes to get out. Just stop it.
That's right.
You know,
that's
like
right.
You have these conversations with yourself and you tell yourself, no, man, why are you thinking like this? Why? And then the next day you're back, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
And I really just felt like, you know what? I have to make a conscious decision.
That's right.
To really be my own cheerleader.
Yeah.
You know? Whether I believe it or not, tell myself, yo, man, you got this. You're
That's
cool.
That's right. That's right.
It's a new day. You're alive.
Yeah.
Why are you stressed about yesterday?
Yeah.
Why are you worried? Live this day. Live this day. This day is for you.
Yeah.
And I had to push myself in that sense, you know?
That's right.
And that's literally the birth of everything. It was experience upon experience that birthed melody, that birthed harmony, that birthed music.
Beautiful. Beautiful. Yeah. So what can people expect from the entire album? Like the sound and everything, what can people expect?
Okay, first things first, the sound is not your ordinary run-of-the-mill music. It's not what you hear every day.
Yeah.
This music was literally written and based off emotions and the fact that people are hurting. So the way it was written was, it was written from a point of hurt to a point of understanding the hurt and understanding you want to get out of it.
Yeah.
Or understanding your struggle and wanting to get out of it and making the conscious decision, the next step. Then the next step is following that very decision you've made. So
That's
staying
right.
steadfast to the choices you've made now for your new existence.
Yeah.
Then the next phase is speaking about building that strength now.
Mm.
Okay, now I understand my problem and I know what I need to do.
Yeah.
Now I'm rolling with that. Every day I'm speaking to myself and I'm encouraging myself.
That's right.
Every day, and it's working. Mm. So now, how do I bring this into a place of joy where I can start to look at what I came from and to start celebrating that, you know?
Mm.
And that's covering a whole cycle of mental, mental sort of issues that we go through that we don't know how to figure out. You know?
What genre will you classify the music under?
I've been classified as a lot of things, to be honest. It's, I mean, people have called this music jazz, which is pretty much what it is being sold as at the moment, you know? Me personally, I would call it fusion.
Okay.
It has elements of pretty much everything. Mm. Styles of writing.
Yeah.
Ways of thinking. Mm. Just conceptual writing.
Okay.
So it's not necessarily a style of music. It's a fusion of different styles of music.
Okay.
Definitely, okay. Yeah. Okay.
Tell me, yeah. My brother. When you look at this entire industry,
yeah.
What scares you the most?
What scares me the most?
Yeah.
Do I start at 1 or 100? Like, wow. Bro, if I must be honest with you, it's even tough to talk about, you know, because as an artist and as someone that's just dropped, I'm dealing with these things,
yeah.
You know, and it's
yeah.
The fact that it's not that the infrastructure is not there. It is there. The problem here is either someone is taking money from us as artists
yeah.
in order to build our careers. So we are not receiving anything from even whether it be government, whether it be anything,
yeah.
just to pursue the career itself,
yeah.
In itself. There's no backing for that unless there is a hype. So that leaves an artist in a very desolate place, because me as an artist, I believe in my music.
That's right.
You as a person taking on this music,
yeah.
If you don't believe in it as the way I do, or as are you, if you are not as excited about it as I am,
yeah.
How am I supposed to believe in my own music? You know what I mean?
Yeah,
if I speak to you, if I call you and I say, listen, I have an issue with this. Don't tell me you can't fix it.
That's right.
Say to me rather, listen, I'm not sure what I can do about this now.
Yeah.
Let me make a few calls, and that puts someone at ease. Not you saying, hey man, the industry's crap, bro. I don't even know what to do. Like, how are you, like, you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So this makes artists so despondent to even try. I mean, I've worked on idols for many years. And I know so many great vocalists.
That's right.
But they just would never do it. And it's a great opportunity.
It's sad.
But they will never do it because the industry has forced us to believe that there's no one covering for us. There's no one standing for us.
Yeah.
So people just disintegrate, you know? They just become something else.
Yeah.
You know, because they know once I go into this thing, that even to your very personal friends,
yeah.
When it happens, it's like, yo, I know I don't have money,
yeah.
But you built this thing with me.
That's it.
Are we in or are we not? And to hear a no from that respect is, it's tough.
Yeah.
You know, it's really tough. If anything, I say a prayer every day just for the people that are at the top, you know, just to really consider the fact that you are not just crushing dreams.
That's right.
You are making a dream not even worth dreaming.
Yeah.
Because you don't care enough. And you are there at the top. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
If anything, put money into people.
That's right.
So that they can do the work if you can't get to it.
That's right.
You know what I mean? Be fair. Just be fair, you know?
Yeah.
With people's talent.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
I see. Great. But how can people get hold of you if they want to book you and your band for shows and all that?
That's a very good question, brother. If anything, people can get hold of me on my Instagram page. This is Leagan_StarChild.
Email address?
My email address is leagues@yahoo.com. So it's leagz@yahoo.com.
Okay.
I don't have management.
Okay.
So I am what it is, if you'd like to see me.
That's it.
Find me.
All right. Good, man. Bro, thanks a lot for coming through, man.
Bro, I really, thank you so really much enjoyed
your music,
you,
and I cannot wait for the next one. The stage is all yours, bro.
Thank you.
Take it over.
Thank you so much for having me, man. I'm
always really, a pleasure.
I'm really always honored to be here, and thank you for allowing me to express certain things that are on my heart and certain things that are on my mind.
Right.
Thank you so much for this opportunity.
It's a pleasure, man.
Pleasure, brother.
Take it away.
Thank you. I'll be there in a flash.
Alright guys, that's it for the day. Thank you so much for hanging out with me, myself, and my guest, StarChild, right here on The Sound of Silence. I had a beautiful, beautiful time. Great music indeed, and I'm sure you also did. Look, stay safe, and I will see you same time next week, same place. God bless. Bye-bye.